Okay. Let us go to logistics, sales and distribution, master data, conditions, select using condition type, VK, well, I go in the change mode. Okay, before that, let me open a sales order, /VA01. My document type is OR 1000 1000. Pricing. And you said that what the system is saying, mandatory condition CR00 is missing. Okay. CR00 is our, okay, the obligatory condition CR00 does not exist. Okay. So PR00 is our main price. So now I am going to maintain the pricing for this article. So I go to the conditions. Select using condition type, create. What the system said, PR00 was missing, so I am going to maintain PR00. So PR00 is my price. Okay, before getting into this, okay, when somebody says the price of an, I am selling this article for $100, does that $100 go into a, is that $100 a single entity or is it a result of multiple components? Hello? If somebody says that they are selling an article for $100, it is not that that $100 is a single entity. That $100 is made of multiple components. For example, you have your landed cost, above which you add your freight, your discounts, your taxes, your surcharges, then you add your margin and finally arrive at a sales price, that is your overall net value of the price. Okay. And we maintain that base price or something. Okay. So let me say, out of $100, my price is 60 rupees, okay. Then I add a freight of 10 rupees, 70, okay. Then I add a tax of 20%, 70 plus 20, 8.4, okay. So 94.6, okay. Then I give some this to my customer. Then I give some a discount to my customer. Let me say some 10% of 60, which means till now I have got 94 minus 6, okay, 88, okay. Then the system adds up the margin of 12 rupees, then it rounds to 100, okay. So when I am pricing initially, there are certain options, okay. I can maintain a uniform price for everybody across my organization. So whomever buys that article, they will be paying, let me say, $100. Okay. Then I can specify some special pricing. For example, for all my people, wholesale customers, I give it for $80. Whereas for all my retail customers, I gave it for $90. Okay. For all the end users, my price is $100. Okay, so on based on customer groups, I can define different prices. Else, I can define more specific for a customer. For example, if the customer A02 asks, I can give him for $80. If the customer A05 asks, A05, let me say he is a new customer. So I need not give a much special price to him. So I can give him $90. Okay. So you can specify price at any for any combination. These are all the most used examples. If you want, you can still give detail. Variable pricing, like whomever buys in a particular city, they will get one price, or whomever buys a particular distribution channel, so they must get a different price. So your pricing is so vast and it is so variable, okay, that it can be defined based on your business needs only. However, SAP has some preconfigured scenarios for pricing. Okay. So PR00 is my pricing condition type, and I go and click the key combination. I could see that I have three choices for entering the material. For example, if I want to make any customer specific price, then I have to use this first combination. If I want to use the price list category, for example, for my industrial customers, those kind of things, then I can use the price list category. Else, whomever, any term they can hurry by, I want to maintain a single price, then I go for material with release status. Okay. So let me go into this customer with and material with release status. Okay. So as of now, I am trying to create the record for 6A02. So my amount is 395 euros per piece. So when creating the price, I create with a validity. By default, the system takes the 3112999, that is almost your eternity, as the end period of the validity. But I don't want to do that. Instead, I want to maintain the price for only today, 0308-2011. Okay. So this is my customer specific price. So let me save it. I come to my sales order. So /MEA01. Okay, now the system has taken the price 395 euros. I select that line, I go to conditions, that is my coin icon. I go to conditions, I can see the system has taken the price PR00. How it had taken, because there were already three combinations when I was trying to create the condition records. So that is what I go to, there are three records. Now I want to know from which combination, for which combination the system had taken the prices. Okay. So I go to the sales order. In the condition, there is something called as analysis. Click the analysis. You can see what is the pricing procedure that is being used for, and go to the PR00. In the PR0, there are four combinations. Okay. So first one is active. So which means the system says that it has taken the value for this. That is for the combination of this customer and this material, the price has found, the system has found a value. Let me create another sales order for the same article but with different customer. The system says mandatory condition PR00 is missing. Just now we maintained the price, but still why the system is saying mandatory condition PR00 is missing? Because when we created the price, we created the price for the specific customer, that is for the customer S62A02. So for that customer the price was there, but for this customer A01 we didn't maintain any pricing. Okay. So let me say A01 is not my priority customer, so I don't want to maintain any special prices for him. So I want to want this customer to get the normal price whomever buys it. So I go to the key combination, I select the material with release status. My material is 101. For whomever buys, I am going to price them for 425. 03082011. Okay. So now I have made the, now I have entered two types of, prices of two extremes. For example, one is for if this is my customer, then it is a price. That is the most specific SAP can define. You cannot get more specific than that. Okay. So when you define any record value at the customer level, that is the most specific. Which means you can have 1 lakh customers. But if you are choosing, okay, like you cannot maintain individual price for all these 1 lakh customers. Okay. So but there are some people for whom you are going to maintain special prices. So that is the most specific. And the next one, what we just created now, that is material with release status, that's it. Whomever buys the system doesn't bother about that. Okay. The system is going to take 425 euros for this article. Okay. So now I am going to the another sales order, OR. I'm going for A01. Pricing. The system had taken 425. Okay. So I go to the conditions and analysis, and I can find out why the system had taken this 425 euros. Why it didn't take that 395, which I maintained some time back. So I go to analysis, PR00. First, the system says the condition record is missing. What is my first combination or this thing? Customer, for any customer material, customer material combination. Okay, this customer is there, but for this material, there is no price. So that is why the system says condition record is missing. Then the system comes to the second one. It looks for the document currency and material. Document currency EUR and material, that specific and price list 03. For this combination, price is not there. Then it checks for some other currency. At least if document currency is not there, let me check in some other currency. No, it is not executed. Then finally it comes to the most broadest one, which means for this sales organization, distribution channel, this material, that's it. Irrespective of who buys it, or which type of customer buys it, or which price list customer buys it, it doesn't bother. So this is the most broad any system can go in terms of pricing. So then the system says, okay, there is a generic price or common price for this article. So then the system takes that and comes into, and fetches that value into your sales order. Okay. So this is how in reality also the prices are being maintained. It is not like if there are 5 customers, it is not like all the 5 pay the same value. The prices can be different based on the customers, customer group or individual customers. They may be your priority customer. Sometimes you want to define prices for wholesale chain price or retail chain price. Okay, so that is what we are going to see the configuration now. Okay, so this is called as, pricing is normally carried out by using a technique called as condition technique. Okay. condition technique is most important. Why I am taking pricing now? Because it uses a technique called as condition technique, and condition technique is used wherever the word determination comes. For example, three good determination, that uses condition technique. Your material determination, that also uses condition technique. Your output determination, that also uses condition technique. Account determination, again condition technique. So even though people say condition technique is synonymous with pricing, condition technique is the one which is used in all these areas wherever you have to determine something. Determination, wherever determination comes, obviously it is going to use the condition technique. So that is why I am going to take the condition technique first, and then we go into those kind of determination scenarios. Okay. Are you clear? Okay. So when I enter the condition type PR00 and press key combination, I get some choices. Choices of customer and material combination, or the price list and material combination, or just materials. How I get these combinations? Because I have to maintain the condition table for this. So if I don't want, tomorrow if my customer says, okay, my client says, this is the standard one SAP has given, it is fine, but I want one more detail. I mean, for example, I want to define a specific price for my wholesale customers or bulk buyer. Can you maintain that? You can always do that. Okay. So now what I am going to do is, I am going to add a new combination of price group and material. So the condition technique always starts with the creation of condition table. Okay. So when you say condition table, you have to create with fields, with the combination of fields that is required by your business. In my case, I had three combinations. I mean, just now we saw in PR00, we had three combinations. One is customer and material combination. Second one is price list and material combination. Third one is just material. Now I have to, I am going to create a new combination for price group and material. Where this price group and material fit in the the specific or broad combination? I had told the customer is the most specific and just material is the most broadest one. So this price group and material combination must fit somewhere in between these extremes. Okay. So when you are defining new condition tables, you must always find out that it must fit in some of the logic. For example, what I am saying is, like, if I now create a new combination and assign it after my material, okay, then what happens? The system will first look for customer price. No, it won't be there. Then it will look for price list. If it is maintained, it will be taken, else it won't be there. Let me assume it is not maintained at the price list level. So then the system excludes that conditional step also. Then it comes to material. Obviously, you are going to maintain the just material level pricing for your business, because out of 1 lakh it's not possible to segregate each customer into some combination and then maintain the prices for that group or list or something. It is not possible. Obviously, you are going to maintain the prices for most general one. Okay. So the system will take the price. If you maintain the price group after that, the system, what it will do, it will take the material price and say, okay, I had found out a condition record and let me terminate the remaining conditions or remaining accesses. So even though you have maintained the price group and material combination pricing, the system won't take that. So to avoid this, when you are defining any new condition table, you have to figure out that broad or specific, that capability and you have to fit in between the extremes. Okay. So as of now, I'm going to create first my customer group, sorry, price group, and the for price group and material combination, and I'm going to fit it immediately after the customer, because my customer obviously belongs to some group. So where I can see that price group in a customer, I go to the sales area data of the customer. Okay, let me say 01. I go to sales area data. In the sales, in the pricing and statistics, there is something called as price group. Okay. So let me say that my customer 01 is a new customer. Okay. So I'm going to maintain the different values for my another customer. Okay. Is it clear, guys? I could see an extremely studious silence. Hello. Sometimes I feel like I am talking alone. Okay. So my customer 01 is a new customer. Okay. So let me say this. Because why I am coming and changing this, because I want two things. One thing, I want to know you where this price group is, and second one is I want to maintain. Okay, my 01 is a new customer, and let me say customer 02 is some bulk buyer. Okay, so I maintain 02 as 01. Okay. I said always the condition technique starts with creation of condition table. Okay. So go to IMG, sales and distribution, basic function, pricing, pricing control. First is your condition table. So whenever you are creating a table, obviously, I mean, we all know that SAP is a database driven software, which means everything is stored, or if technical people, they talk in terms of tables and fields, because everything is stored in some table and some fields in that particular table. Okay. So if you want to create a condition table of your own, that fields must be existing already somewhere. Okay. So that is why the system says like allowed fields. Okay. If any field you want is not present in this combination, then you can always ask your ABAP people to create a new table and give the fields for that. For example, let me say my sales document item. Let me say sales document. For example, if I want to say for all my cash sales order, I might want to give a 2% discount. Then the system must take into consideration the document type, because that is how you always define your cash sales. So sometimes I want to say field KUMR. This is my customer. This is my part. Sorry, bill to party. Okay. So all the things must be available before you start creating a condition table. So I am going to create a condition table. Yeah. Table is cross client. Okay, yeah. The thing is like, you always, I mean, you people know that there are so many clients, production client, development client, and other things. Okay. But if it says the table is cross client means, if you make any changes in this table in development, it will automatically get changed in your quality also. Okay. Which means these tables are common for all of your clients. You log into development server and make any changes. But this is the cross client one. So these changes you make, it will always be reflected in the other clients also, development also. By default, the condition table numbering goes like 1 to 500 is the standard SAP table, and 501 to 999999, that is the customized table. So whenever you create, you have to maintain this numbering range. You have to use between 501 to 999. So 997 has been taken, 54. Okay, let me take 996. Okay, fine. 996. So, what I am going to create now, this is your scrolling. You can use the page down button if you are using the keyboard, and if you are using the mouse, you can use this. So I am going to create for the combination of sales organization, distribution channel, sales organization, where is my distribution channel, sales organization, distribution channel. I want to maintain prices for specific price group, which means for new customers I want to maintain a different price. For bulk customers, I want to maintain a different price. Where I made these changes, whether a customer is a bulk customer or new customer, I made it in the sales area data of the sold to party. So, I have maintained added the sales organization distribution channel. Then, I come to the price group. I just double click, it will get added. Hello.
Appa, naan class la irukken, appa pesunga. Koopidrenga. Seri, okay, naan koopidren.
So then I go to the price group. Then did you notice that I didn't go on the ascending order or descending order? I am maintaining it on some specific level. So if I maintain the price group first and sales organization next or distribution channel, then it's going to be confusing. And another thing is like, if you go to here, okay, for the combination, let me say, you are entering the materials as the footer field or text field, whereas the sales organization and the distribution channel are made as header. That is, they are staying at the top level. Okay. So that is why, like, I want to maintain these things as the header level. So that is why I am putting in that order. If you mess up with this order, then you will have problems in creating that. Okay. So that is why you maintain in that first the topmost one, that is sales organization, distribution channel, and price group. These three are going to be my headers field sort of. It means here, no, or you are seeing in the screen, TR00 screen. If you are going to create, it will be like sales organization, distribution channel, below is the pricing group, and below that it is going to be the material. Then it will be easy for me to create that. Some people, yeah, you can. But at the end of the day, like, it must be in a logical manner. You cannot put material in the header, and you can do that. You can put the material in the header and you can put the price group in the item level, which means for this sales organization, this distribution channel, for this material, for price group 01 is one price, for price group 02 is another price. Okay. But if you do that way, what happens is you have to maintain all the articles individually. You have to come out, then enter the another article, for that article 01 price group 1 price is different, price group 2 price is different, okay, you have to come back again. So the maintaining of data will be different. So that is why you always try to put the material at the footer level. Okay. So then I come to the, yeah, you can do that. You can do that, but with the help of SAPer. You have to tell them. I mean, most of the fields will be available in SAP itself. Yeah, sometimes it happens. It happens. What one time, what we did in the one project was, they wanted the loyalty points to be tracked. So loyalty point is not in the standard SAP. So we maintained our different table, and we based on the purchase or condition type value, then we defined the logic for the this point, loyalty point. Okay. So that table, that field where everything is customized. Okay, so it happens sometimes. Okay. So I have added the combination of sales organization, distribution channel, price group and material. Okay. Now I want to see which is my that footer level thing. So I go to technical view, sales organization, distribution channel, price group are in the header level, and you can see the material is automatically taken. The last one is automatically taken in the footer field, and you are going to enter value for that. So that is why it is a text field. Okay. Now I am going. Footer value is this. This material is your footer. Okay. If I don't maintain the material as footer, then it will come in the header. Okay. That will be a sort of messy. Okay. So I have, okay, it is fine. Then I go to the generation. Click this button, the system will create here. Okay. When creating, for your case, it will be like, in case of implementation, you will be entering a package, but we are using IDES, so always use the local object. What is a local object means? Like when you are creating, if you are assigning it to some package, okay, so it will be, you can export or transport that to your other clients. So, of course, even though, I mean, in this case, we need not that, because it is, it says that this table is cross-client, which means whatever changes you make here, it is going to be reflected or changed in other clients also. But there are certain things, like your document types and other things. So when you create the document types for the first time, the system would have given you a similar box. For the time that you assign the, you enter your transport numbers and other things. If you create anything as local object, you cannot export that from that client to some other client. Okay. So that is why, like, there is a difference between your local object and any object assigned to package. Okay. Now I have created a table 996. Okay. So let me say that I have already created the tables 304, 305, 306 by my own. Okay. Now, if I go to PR00, if I click the key combination, I could see the customer material comes first, the price list comes next, and the material comes the last. So there is some sort of sequence defined. Okay. So you search this table first. If it is found, take else come to the another table price list. Okay. If you find there anything there, take it. Else you come to the third table. So we are defining a sequence of tables in the sequence which the system has to access those records for those tables. Okay. So since we are accessing those tables in a particular sequence, we are going to maintain a access sequence in the SPRO. Now I have created all my condition tables. Now I am going to my access sequence. In this access sequence, there is not much activity in this access sequence, except you are going to say this is going to be my sequence. So my standard access sequence is PR02. Okay. I select this and I go to and see the accessor. Can you see the system? My step number 10 is customer material. My step number 20 is price list category. And my step number 40 is material release status. Since I have arranged this in this particular sequence, when I am creating the price, the system takes this sequence. In the actual sequence, if I had maintained this customer material in the last, when you are going to create the prices in the week 11, it will be coming in the last. Okay. So the sequence of entering the data is controlled by your access sequence. Like your item numbers in your sales order, here also they had given provisions for entering or adding any sequence at a later time. Now I am going to add my newly created table between 10 and 20 because I want the system to check for customer level first. If it doesn't find any value for customer, then it must come and search in the customer group or price group. If it doesn't find there only, then it has to go to price list and individual material. So I am going to insert the newly created table between 10 and 20. So I am going to create a new entry. Let me say I am going to maintain in 5 and my created table is 996. Okay. Since we have saved it as local object, it says like it is local, no problem. Okay. If you come and, if you see there is something called as requirement here. Okay. So if you want to make any check and then let the system access this particular value, then you can enter the requirements here. You will see that, in the same sequence, there is another table having the requirement. I will explain that. Okay. The last one is the exclusive indicator. If you mark this as exclusive, if the system finds a value for this 996 table, that is for the combination of price group and material, if the system finds a value, then it excludes the remaining tables. Okay. So that is the meaning. And most of the people, what they do normally, once you have created the accessors, you have to initialize the fields because all the fields are taken from different tables. You have taken fields from different tables and you have put together in your condition table. Okay. Since it is taken up from somewhere, from some other positions, you have to initialize that. Which means like when you are creating a new, when you had just installed a new water connection or bore pump, so what you do normally, you initially prime it by pouring some water inside that, close that, create a vacuum, then you click that, then you switch on the power button, then only this water will come. So it means you do the priming activity first. Similarly, you have to carry out the initial functionality when after assigning the access sequence. So I select that. I do nothing. I select that. I go to field. The system will say field assignment has not been yet. No problem. I come to this screen. Then I go back. Okay. Now I have successfully inserted a new search criteria or new combination of pricing, which means first it is going to search for customer specific price, then it is going to search for price group, then only it will go for price list category and material. Okay. So here if you see for the steps 20 and 30 you have the same condition table but with something called a requirement. In the second line I have the requirement number 3. Okay. Before going into that requirement, let me see what is this combination for price list category, for currency and material with list status, which means your pricing is going to be based on the currency. I can say that I am maintaining the prices in euro or USD. Okay. But my sales document will be having one pricing currency. Had anybody noticed that the pricing currency in your sales order? Till now, I think you might not have noticed because there was, it is in euro. In which screen you can find the pricing currency? Can you see the header data? There is a document currency. So this document currency is fetched from your customer master. So let us see customer master. Okay, coming back here. Okay, so which means there are two types of currency. One is called as document currency and another one is your normal currency based on which your price is maintained. So let me say my document currency is euro, but I have maintained the pricing in dollars only. Okay, so the system will check for the price list and euro combination. If it is there, it will take. If it is not there, because right now I said that I hadn't maintained the price in euro, I have maintained in the US dollars only. Then I create then I enter the table again. Now I am putting a requirement saying that foreign currency document, which means if your document is not in euro, or else if your document is not in USD, but your price is maintained in some other currency, then I am telling the system, check for this requirement. If the price is maintained in some other currency also, if so, you can take it. So what happens? Your customer will be saying like, okay, out of 4 items, 3 will be in euros, 1 can be in USD. The system will automatically take the exchange set types and convert it accordingly. So that is the requirement. So in this case I had said, check for the local currency first. If it is not there, then check for the foreign currency. So now I am saving it. Go back. Now if I try to create a week 11, and I will be getting the another combination. So let me come out of this. Week 11 key combination. Can you see the newly created table has come in? This is because we have created the table and assigned it to the access sequence. Okay. Now, we had created the table, we had assigned the access sequence, but how did it come into the condition type? Because this access sequence what we have created is assigned to the condition type. So, what is my condition type here? My condition type is CR00. So, define condition type and maintain condition type. My condition type is PR00. I go to the condition type, I could see the access sequence is assigned here. That is how the changes I made in the access sequence, that is the newly created table I inserted into the access sequence. That is how the tables are coming in when I am creating the condition records in the easy access screen. So, to sum it up, we had done three steps. One is we created the condition table. Second, we assigned those condition tables into the access sequence. Then we assigned the access sequence into the condition type. And the next step is we have defined condition types, we have defined access sequence and everything. But how does the system know, okay, this is the condition type I have to use? That has to be assigned to some pricing procedure. I come to my sales order. Here? Access sequence is assigned to condition type. Okay, then the condition type must be assigned to the procedure. So I go to condition. So I go to the condition, I go to analysis. I could see there is a procedure, and inside that procedure only all these condition types are there. Okay. So I have to assign the condition type to any of my procedure. Okay. So that is how the system takes that condition type into your sales order. In your sales order, only condition type cannot flow. In the sales order, only the pricing procedure flows. Since the condition types are assigned to your pricing procedure, it is taking up in the sales order. What is my procedure? Standard procedure is RVAA01. I select that, I go to control data. Here I can see my PR00 is assigned to. If I remove the PR00 here, then the system won't take up the PR00 here in the sales order. Okay. So that is the link between your condition type and pricing procedure. So let us sum it up again. First, create the condition table. Assign those condition tables to a access sequence. Then link the access sequence with your condition type and put the condition types into your condition and pricing procedure. Now finally the system has to determine which pricing procedure the system must take while creating a sales order. Okay. Do anybody remember the sales order screen, sales order customizing screen? V0V8, I go to V0V8, my standard is OR. In the OR, at the time I told like let us leave that particular field, document pricing procedure, we will see it at a later time. So this is that. So your document type has something called a document pricing procedure. Okay. In our case, that is for OR, it is A. And I go to the customer master slash NVB02. Here also I have something called as pricing procedure. Customer pricing procedure is 1. So now based on these two parameters, that is your customer pricing procedure that comes from the customer master of your sold to party, and then the document pricing procedure that comes from the sales document type and the sales area combination, the system is going to determine the pricing procedure. So now go to the defined pricing procedure determination. My combination is 1000 is my sales order, 10 is my distribution channel, 00 is my division, which means B3 is my sales order, sales area. My document pricing procedure is A, my customer pricing procedure is 1. For this combination, I tell system you take the RBA001 as your pricing procedure. Okay. Let me make a small change here. Okay. For this combination, let me say, okay, the system has to determine the another pricing procedure. Anyway, this is a standard setting, so we will come and revert it back again. So first, when I created the sales order, it showed me RVAA01. Just now I have changed the pricing procedure for the combination of sales area and customer pricing procedure and document pricing procedure. Now I am coming out of the sales order and I am going in to find out the system is going to take a new pricing procedure. OR, the same customer, okay, the customer is going to have the document pricing customer pricing procedure of 1, and this order type OR is going to have the document pricing procedure of A. For the combination of sales area and other thing, I go to the condition analysis. I could see the system has taken the another or different pricing procedure based on what I had assigned. Okay. So this is how the system determines the pricing procedure in the sales order. Can anybody repeat for what combination the system determines the pricing procedure? Correct. For this combination, the system determines the sales pricing procedure. Okay, so let me restore this. 1000 10 00 document pricing procedure is A, customer pricing procedure is 1. Hey Tirisha, you have created a sales document type for yourself, no? No, that way we assigned actually. We assigned at the time we said like this, no pricing procedure can be determined. We will fix that now. What is your document type? Z? Z is OR 1005? O is it? Okay. Division is 00. Okay. Z O. Okay. So when I went in, now this is determining the new pricing procedure. Okay. So let us do it. And did you? I think you created some other customer also. But it is not for this sales area. What is another customer? 2577. Okay. So now it says no pricing procedure could be determined. Okay. because it says for the sales area 1005, this division distribution channel 0 is there, and division 00 and my document procedure A and customer pricing procedure 1. For this combination, there is no pricing procedure. So that is why the system couldn't determine the pricing for this. Now I am going to fix this. Okay. So go to determine pricing procedure determination. Okay. So make new entry. One is 005. Another one is O is better. My document pricing procedure is A, customer pricing procedure is 1. For this, I am assigning the procedure of RDAA01. Okay. This condition type, okay, even if you don't fill it, that's fine, no problem. So, I saved it. I come out here. So, now let us say, if you go and create the sales order for this customer, this Sirisha has created and maintained, you can find it. Okay, now the system has taken a price. Material is not different. Sirisha, did you create any material? You didn't create any material. Okay. No problem. Let me go to the system. Condition, nothing is there. No items exist. Now actually where this thing has been solved. Previously you had created this document type, fine. You had created a sales area, that is also fine. But only thing is that you hadn't assigned the pricing procedure earlier. So now I assigned that the system has taken the pricing procedure. Okay. Abhi and Preeti, are you clear? Okay. And I know like the condition technique will be initially intimidating, but once you get comfortable or it will be very easy then. Yeah, Preeti, you are about saying something. Yeah, I'll do that. Okay. So this is how the system or this is how your condition technique works. Tomorrow we will see that what are all those components of pricing and other things. Are you clear what you had seen today? Okay. Yeah, I'll do that. I'll upload it now. Okay. Yeah, we'll catch up tomorrow. Okay.